In this brand new video, you will now discover another data type, sets. Be sure to stick around, and watch until the end of this video, if you want to discover various actions and methods that you can perform on sets, in Python. Please, do not forget to smash that like button, for the YouTube algorithm, since it does really help supporting us, and providing new free content, once a week. Are you interested to be part of this community? All the links are in the description below. Now, let's play this video. Creating a set. There are several ways to create a new set. In Python programming language, the simplest way to create a set is to enclose all of the items, also known as elements, inside curly braces, and separated by commas. It can have any number of items inside, and they can even be of different data types, integer, float, string, boolean, or even another object, which contains other items of different data types, and so forth. Although a set itself is mutable, it cannot contain mutable objects. Therefore, only immutable objects like numbers, strings and tuples can be a set item. But lists and dictionaries are mutable, so they cannot be a set item. Now, let's have a closer look at its syntax, so you can declare your own set and start practicing. Here is an example, in which you want to store a list of strings. First, let's declare an empty set, with empty curly braces. Eventually, you will add all of the strings, so that you can store and then access these values, later on. My set equals, red, green, and, blue, surrounded by curly braces. But, remember, sets do not allow duplicate members, they are automatically removed, during its creation. Consequently, my set which has been declared with the values, red, green, blue, and red again, will only contain these items once, green, blue, and red. As you have seen, a set containing zero items is called an empty set, and you can create one with empty curly braces. But, you can also create a new set in Python using its type constructor, called set. Or, even convert other data types into a set, like string, tuples, or any object of immutable type. This way, you can convert the string, ABC, into a new set, containing the items, A, B and C, but also convert a list or a tuple, which contains the items 1, 2 and 3, into another set. One thing to keep in mind is that this conversion would remove any duplicate members, automatically. That's great, but once you have created your set, you may also want to add other items, or even update some values inside, right? Then, let's see how it all works, in the next section. Please, also check out our blog if you want more examples on digital.academy.free.fr. If you liked this video, please, do not forget to give a thumb up, and subscribe our channel. Digital Academy, learn free. Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe. Hit the notification bell, like, comment, and share.